Control Basic is the programming language used in KMC Conquest controllers. With it, you can write programs that evaluate or modify objects on a controller and send communication messages across the network. We refer to point passing as reading or writing values between controllers or devices on the network. In this video, we are going to focus on the basics of point passing operations, reading and writing data points. KMC Conquest controllers are peer-to-peer, so any controller can read or write points to any other controller on the network. This communication model enables seamless operation between devices. When a controller needs to share values with other devices, it must either send data, known as a write, or receive data, known as a read. First, let's look at reading data. When reading data, the controller generates a request for information from another device. Here, we are reading, or pulling, an outdoor air temperature from a sensor located on another controller. The request is generated and sent to the controller with the outside air sensor. The controller with the outside air sensor receives the request and replies with a message containing the outside air temperature value. When looking at the control basic code with the reads, we can clearly see where that data is coming from, as the information source, or the remote address and object identifier, is specified in the programming. Now, let's look at writing data. Writing is the exact opposite of reading data. If a controller has code to write to another controller, the destination controller will be sent a message with the data specified. For example, this controller is pushing occupancy information to other devices across the network. The receiving controller updates its object information, and the operation in the receiving controller is influenced by the new data. If you are monitoring values on the receiving controller, you may see updating values and not necessarily know where they are coming from. This can complicate troubleshooting, since you'll have to use other tools to know which network devices are sending these messages. Therefore, we recommend that in general, you will want to read data rather than write data. This makes troubleshooting much simpler. It is important to stick to a consistent scheme across your entire network for organization and ease of troubleshooting. Let's look at a schedule example. An air handler controller has the schedule and needs to notify downstream VAV controllers that are dependent on its air supply. We can move that data in two different ways. Using reads, you may choose to add control basic to each VAV that will request this point from the air handler. Conversely, using writes, you may choose to add control basic code to the air handler unit that will push the data to the VAV controllers. In our example, while it may be quicker to add code to the air handler controller, it may make troubleshooting harder later on the VAVs. Practice and experience will help you know when to write and when to read. Reads are safer and easier to troubleshoot when you are getting started with point passing. Above all, being consistent in the way you and your organization write code will increase your efficiency and reduce your troubleshooting time. One thing to note is that whether you use reading or writing schemes, the network traffic generated will still be the same. For systems requiring lots of point passing, or where network bandwidth is already limited, we need a strategy to help reduce the load on the network. To combat network inefficiencies in these systems, we use a concept called tiering. Let's say all the controllers in the system need to know the outside air temperature. Here, we have multiple air handlers and VAVs on multiple MSTP networks, all connected with routers. We could push the outside air value with writes from the controller with the outside air temperature sensor to all the controllers in the system. Given the number of VAVs in our system, this would be a large program and create a single point of failure for point passing. Another way would be to have each VAV read the data. But again, we'd have the same amount of network traffic. With either reads or writes, the outside air requests will all travel across multiple networks to get the outside air value to all the controllers in the system, and all the network segments will see all the messages. This is where a tiering strategy may help. Tiering is the process in which one controller is used to relay data across the network, and then many controllers on the same subnetwork access the data from the intermediate controller. We refer to this as one-to-many. The one-to-many layout limits the messages across some networks, reducing the total number of messages in the system. This results in faster cycle times and lower network loads because some messages will be limited to within their own subnetworks. In our example, we can speed things up and reduce the network load by using tiering. Here, each air handler will request the outside air. The VAVs will then request the outside air from their air handler. Since the outside air requests from the VAVs only go to their air handlers on the same MSTP segment, the number of messages on the network between the air handlers is reduced. Point passing in BACnet networks can seem difficult at first, but practice and using these strategies will increase your overall network efficiency and reduce your troubleshooting times. For more information on Control Basic and point passing, check out the other videos in this series. Or to learn more about any of the solutions from the building geniuses at KMC, visit us on the web at kmccontrols.com.